Historically, our graduation processional has been led by the top-ranking academic students from our junior class. So here are our junior marshals. Sing the Star Spangled Banner, our national anthem, Michael Tokar.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the Rockies' red glares, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the
to lead us in the flag salute, the salutatorian of the class of 2020, Michael Incabo.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
To share her speech, entitled The Duty of the Young, valedictorian of the class of 2020, Drusilla Zeng.
Greetings, class of 2020. We have made it. Despite everything happening in this world right now, we are here graduating. Times are difficult, but that just makes it that much more important that we are here, standing firm and ready to celebrate our accomplishments. As young adults moving into a tumultuous world, we need to be ready to face many challenges, and I think our past experiences will aid us well in all that lies ahead. There's this funny quote, and I think it should be very relevant to us as young people. I am not yet young enough to know everything. Ridiculous quote said by ridiculous characters, but the naive traits represented here can be applied to our generation. While there is a fair or unfair comparison, it is my opinion that young people like to think we know everything because we feel so strongly about everything. We care about the world and we feel fully inspired by the injustices we see around us. Looking at history, in the 60s, young people were standing up for issues we saw in the world. Protesting, speaking out, daring the world to see its flaws and to improve upon them. In the 70s, they were doing the same thing, for many of the same issues. Same thing can be found in the 80s, 90s, early 2000s, now, tomorrow, and until forever. The reason for this cycle is even as times change, the spirit will always remain the same. People stand up for what they think is right, and, unfortunately, many of the big issues remain the same, too. They linger, remain unresolved, and chafe against those that they affect. But where did the youth go? If people from every generation hated these issues and spoke out against them, where are they now when the problems are still so painfully present? There comes a breaking point for most people, a point where the issues they fight seem so omnipresent that their hope begins to flag. In our youth, we have not yet been accustomed to the world as it is, but over time, we are desensitized. We lose that fire within us to chase lofty ideals and begin to look at the world with a more resigned practicality. Yes. Youth idealism is temporary, and if we are unable to translate our feelings into meaningful action, we will just be another chapter of a failed revolution, written off as another mass of young people who say everything and do nothing. But injustice, greed, violence, and evil are permanent, and they don't stop when we stop standing up. we just get stronger, bigger, and more malicious as we too are absorbed into this ugly cycle, complicit to let it rain unchecked when we become too tired to fight. A quote by the poet Adrienne Rich goes, "In a world where language and naming are power, silence is oppression, is violence. What we fail to stand up for will make a larger impact on how our history will be written than what we do stand up for. Our words can be foolish, but our silence is deadly. I am not yet young enough to claim to fight everything, nor that the utopia we yearn for is realistic, but it would be a weight on our conscience if we don't fight, if we don't at least try to address the obvious cracks we have in our world, while we are still young and we have this energy within us. The time to stand up was centuries ago, but we can always start now. There has been a lot of progress, but we have much further to go. Being here, we should be thankful for those around us who have helped us get to this point. Our family, friends, teachers, mentors, coaches, all of the wonderful staff here, we owe everything to those around us. No one lives in a vacuum. Every kind word you have heard, every hand that has reached out for you, every gesture you have seen has had an impact into shaping you into who you are today. In turn, strive to be that kind word, outstretched hand, and thoughtful gesture to someone else. Regarding impacting someone's life, first and foremost, I'd like to thank my grandparents. They are, and I do not say this lightly, excellent people. They were my teachers in every aspect when I was younger, teaching me to ride my bike, add these finicky fractions, and to be a disciplined, loving, and honorable person by example. I want it to be known that everything that I am today, and anything good I will ever be, comes from their impact. A person would also like to thank my parents for the hard work they put in. I'm difficult, foolish, and hard to love, but I am grateful that they still stand beside me and love me all the same. I'd like to thank Mrs. Italia as well for being one of the best teachers I ever had. I hope to grow up half as often as she is and a quarter as sharp. I'd also like to thank Mrs. Velasco, Mr. Infante for all the hard work they have put in as teachers and for the senior class as a whole. I'd also like to thank all my friends for putting up with me and for supporting me when I needed it most. I'd like to thank the Board of Education, the administration, the PTA, and all the staff in the district, from the elementary school teachers to the custodians to the nurses to the wonderful librarians that are tired of dealing with us for helping us get through these unprecedented times. Your dedication, flexibility, and hard work is noticed and appreciated by all of us. I thank everyone, and I thank all of you for being the environment that has shaped me into who I am today. Class of 2020, we have made it, but we have much to go. But be proud of yourselves and be ready to continue this journey. History has its eyes on you, me, everyone here and in this world, so make sure when the pages turn 60 years, we won't be on the wrong side of it.
To share her speech, entitled Silver Lining. The Governor's Educator of the Year for Fairlawn High School is Kathy Menigan.
Hi, everybody. This is Mrs. Menigan, Teacher of the Year, this famous year. Here we are at virtual graduation, definitely the first for all of us. Thinking back to September, who would have thought that we'd be celebrating the end of the year this way? I don't like to say socially distanced. In some ways, such as online meetings and seeing each other outdoors, we are more connected than ever. I think that physical distance is a preferable term. I actually marvel at how ingenious we have become. A virtual graduation? You may feel like you've already moved on, or you may feel so confused you don't know what day it is. Should you be wearing your pajamas or something else? But here we are, graduation class of 2020, a year never to be forgotten. We are all wondering when things will return to normal, and what will the new normal be? Should we even want the old normal? These are certainly the craziest times that I have ever experienced. Over the past few months, we have all experienced the pandemic differently. Some of us have faced the disease firsthand or lost beloved family members or friends. We have had to adapt to new ways of living, getting provisions, and getting along and just dealing with those with whom we share living space. We have had to get used to smaller spaces and physical distancing while maintaining actual social interactions. We have struggled with distance learning, oh yes. We have faced sadness, fear, and uncertainty, but we have learned to accept and reinvent our lives. You seniors especially ended your year without the fanfare that you expected, without prom, grad ball, Virginia Beach, senior cut day, and other celebrations. And I would love to be signing your yearbooks right now. Yet every cloud has a silver lining. In case you haven't heard this metaphor from a play by John Milton in 1634, it means that every dark cloud or difficulty in life has a silver lining or something beautiful or gift. In times like these, it's so important to try to move forward. We must stop to recognize and appreciate the silver linings. For all of you seniors right now, your first thought may be that the only silver lining these days is that we've all been able to sleep in more. From a health perspective, this is a benefit not to be underestimated. Your families should be seeing improvements in your mood and behavior, attention, memory, decision-making, creativity, and academic performance. These are silver linings. However, to enumerate a few more personal benefits, we have all had opportunities to learn, sometimes with great pain and anguish, in my case anyway, from technology. 3 months ago, I never thought I'd be able to figure out Zoom or how to order groceries online. But now, instead of having to walk 6 miles through sleet, snow, and germs to secure a supply of bathroom tissue, I can stock my shelves with flax seeds and coconut flour digitally. I've had the opportunity to connect with people to whom I rarely speak, as well as with family members near and far on Zoom. I experienced being cared for by people bringing me food when my husband and I were sick with COVID. I have had lots of quiet time to focus on my work and read many books. I take virtual violin lessons and practice my violin nearly every day. While online, I have also learned many interesting skills, such as how to make sourdough bread or how to garden in shady places. I've been trading plant seedlings with other local gardeners who I've met while taking walks. I mentioned to someone that I love rhubarb, and the next morning I woke up to find an enormous grocery bag filled with those big red stalks on my porch. So I will now spend the rest of this month baking strawberry rhubarb pies and making jam. If anyone knows of any other great things to make with rhubarb, let me know. I have tried many things that I never tried before. Notice I didn't say anything about cleaning out closets. And most importantly, I've learned to appreciate my blessings. We all know pandemics such as the bubonic plague, polio, Spanish influenza have been with us for a long time, but there have always been silver linings. William Shakespeare wrote 3 of his famous tragedies, King Lear, Macbeth, and Antony and Cleopatra, during the bubonic plagues in which nearly half of Europe died. Between 1603 and 1613, he endured at least 3 periods of quarantine, and according to the Guardian newspaper, when Shakespeare's powers as a writer were at their height, the Globe and other London playhouses were shut for an astonishing total of 78 months. Many great works of art have been created during times of distancing. Let that inspire you for a moment. Sir Isaac Newton was a student at Cambridge when in 1665, another wave of Black Death hit. Cambridge sent all students home. While stuck in quarantine for 2 years, he studiously did his distance learning homework. He did not sit around in his pajamas all day long eating Doritos. The mathematical problems he diligently worked later led to the invention of calculus. Now, you may not think of calculus as a silver lining, but it is used to improve the architecture not only of buildings, but also of important infrastructures such as bridges. Not only that, but with a few prisms and a hole bored in the shutters of his bedroom so that only a small beam of light could come through, he came up with theories of optics. And right outside his window was an apple tree, the apple tree that led to theories about gravity. When he returned to school 2 years later, he had many new theories. When the Spanish flu infected 1/3 of the world's population in 1918, it too had a silver lining. It, along with the casualties of World War I, created a shortage of labor, which meant that women had to become part of the labor force. This necessity for workers led to unexpected social changes, opening up new opportunities for women, and in the process, transforming life in the United States. Women undertook a vital role in the workforce just before the 19th Amendment was to be ratified, which granted them the right to vote. Globally, thanks to coronavirus, we have reduced our carbon emissions substantially, and pollution has dropped to unprecedented levels. With people sheltering in place worldwide due to the corona pandemic, we have used a great deal less fossil fuels, and the air and water have really cleared up. We have witnessed the impact this has had. The Himalaya Mountains are visible in India for the first time in 30 years, as are the San Gabriel Mountains, which are usually hidden behind the choking brownish smog for which Los Angeles is well known. Animals have been roaming more freely in residential and urban areas. Wild goats have been seen strolling through a Welsh town. Wild boars have been running rogue through cities in Spain, Turkey, and Israel. Cougars have been found wandering the streets of Santiago, Chile. Sea lions are making themselves comfortable in the streets of Puerto Vallarta, Ayora in the Galapagos. The water flowing through the canals of Venice is now clear enough to see the dolphins. And yes, I fact-checked. Although these changes are unfortunately temporary, they are showing us real possibilities for our future. They are showing us that we actually can make improvements to our environment. We are seeing possibilities and opportunities if we choose to try and learn from these events. We are witnessing the potential for sustainable coexistence with our fellow creatures, if you make it happen. Inevitably, the impact of the virus will be felt for a long time, but it has exposed serious flaws in our economic, environmental, and healthcare systems. For the first time, we are really expressing deep gratitude to healthcare workers, food supply workers, garbage collectors, mail carriers, and many more now deemed essential. Our eyes have been opened to food supply chains, farmers, harvest workers, truckers, food processors, and grocery store employees. I have even received emails from students thanking me and other teachers for all the work we have done during this time to keep education up and running. Thank you so much. This quarantine gives us a great opportunity to rethink and improve the systems we have in place. Thanks to COVID, everyone is now paying attention, and we have a catalyst to motivate us to overhaul some of our institutions, as well as our personal daily behaviors. As summer is upon us, in these past tumultuous few weeks, we have witnessed pain, human anguish, anger, and injustice, but also the love and generosity that is the best of the human spirit. We are deciding in this moment what kind of a country we really want to be. What can we expect from our fellow human beings, and what can we expect from ourselves? We must look inward as our country struggles to recover and to redefine itself and find a silver lining there too. So you, the class of 2020, as crazy as it sounds, have much to be thankful for. These are dire times. Challenges have taught you lessons that you are only beginning to know. You will have bragging rights years from now for this incredible year of your life, and you will one day tell your children and grandchildren what it was like to be living through such unprecedented events. You now have learned to focus on what is most essential in your lives. Do not forget the lessons here. You have witnessed history in the making. With your experiences and heightened awareness, you can help make needed changes and vital improvements in our world. Please use this opportunity to kickstart this process. Now, put away your cell phones and get to work. And always remember to look for the silver lining. As an educator, I know that you are the silver lining, the gift that gives us hope.
Well, it goes without saying, this is unlike any graduation speech I have ever written and delivered before. This certainly is not what any of us would have wanted, but it is what we have. It is also historical. No graduating class will be remembered quite like the class of 2020. So, on with our virtual graduation ceremony. Before I begin, I'd like to pause for a moment of silence for all those who have been impacted by the coronavirus pandemic, especially those who have been lost, like our beloved bus driver, Jerry Genuino. During this silence, I ask that we also reflect on the circumstances surrounding the protests taking place all over our country. Family is the most important thing of all, so I would like to welcome the family members and friends who are watching this special celebration. You have been these young people's teachers every second of their lives. We have educated them for only a very short while. We thank you for loaning them to us over the last 4 years. That period of loan was cut a few months short this year, and you've been doing some family overtime in quarantine. So, class of 2020, please say thank you to the loved ones gathered with you now. I would also like to acknowledge support of our Board of Education, led by President Ron Barbarullo, himself a proud parent of a class of 2020 graduate, and Vice President Elise Frankel. Also, the Town Council, represented by proud Cutter alum, Mayor Kurt Peluso. I would also like to thank our Central Office Administrators, led by Superintendent Nick Norcia, our district supervisors, and from Fairlawn High School, our administrative team, especially Class of 2020 Assistant Principal Nicole Matina, class advisors, senior parents, and PTA, especially Kelly O'Shea. There has been so much hard work taking place behind the scenes. Think outside the box and find ways to recognize and celebrate the Class of 2020. Last, but certainly not least, the unsung heroes, our administrative assistants, custodians and maintenance crews, musicians, staff, and the Lane Group, all of whom worked so hard on behalf of the Class of 2020. Now, I would like to recognize our Fairlawn High School Educators of the Year, led by Ms. Catherine Menigan, Fairlawn High School Teacher of the Year, and Ms. Dina DeSantis, Educational Support Professional of the Year. I thank our faculty for their support of our graduates and the excellent work they do every day with our students. In particular, I would like to recognize our retirees, staff members who have served our students with dedication. Our retiring and retired staff are Vice Principal Matt Kahn and teachers Al Barton, Vincent Casamento, and Paul Larson. I would like to cap off my recognitions by spotlighting our high school and this class of 2020. We had a great year of prideful moments on our competition fields, our performing arts stages, and in our classrooms. Academically, the class of 2020 boasts 13 National Merit Commended Scholars, including Anna Seamus, a National Merit Scholarship winner. Extracurricular activities have always been a strong suit of this class. Along the way, they have earned individual awards and championships in both athletics and fine and performing arts. Students from this class have been accepted into some of the most prestigious institutions in the country, including Ivy League colleges and outstanding technical schools. Not only are they smart, they're also kind and socially conscious. With the incredible challenges facing the human family at this time, the class of 2020 will always be looked to as the leaders of tomorrow. Every day, they are learning from the mistakes made by those that came before them, and funneling their passion into creating a new and better world for all of us. Of course, I would be remiss if I didn't speak a bit about our current circumstances. Though it has been over 3 months since we were living our lives normally, I still keep hoping that I'm going to wake up one day and everything will be normal again. However, we are all adjusting to a new normal. Maybe, just maybe, the class of 2020 will figure out how to make it better than the old normal we were accustomed to. Because, as the confluence of recent events has shown us, perhaps the way in which we were doing our normal living wasn't sustainable for the future. Whether it's how we treat our environment, how we treat each other, or how we heed the forces of Mother Nature, we have been harshly reminded that there is a picture that is much bigger than us. The entities of global warming, institutional prejudice, and the coronavirus are with us. Whether we see them or not, they are profoundly shaping our lives nonetheless. Another lasting lesson of the last several months is crystallized, like so many life lessons, by an ancient philosopher. This time it was Heraclitus of ancient Greece. He posited that no man steps in the same river twice, for it is not the same river, and he is not the same man. Heraclitus meant that the world and everything within it is in a constant state of flux. Though we may want to recreate an experience, we can't, because everything has changed about both us and our surroundings. This may not appear obvious to us, but we all know this to be true. How many times have you tried to rewatch a movie or do something else you loved when you were younger, only to find that it didn't hold up or didn't make you feel the way it did years ago? Such is the scenario we find ourselves in now. There is no way to recreate the past or to make up for lost time. The only thing we can do is move forward, realizing that we are always a different person stepping into a different river. The currents may have shifted dangerously since we last visited, so we must be stronger swimmers. It is on us to practice our swimming so we are ready for whichever way the current might pull us. As I have alluded to on several occasions, the theme of this year's yearbook is to be continued. It, like hashtag class of 2020 strong, is uniquely fit for this class of graduates. Across the country, this class has already begun to embrace the ellipses, those dot, dot, dots, and is living in the moment by strongly acting to shape a new future for themselves and all of us. Our class of 2020 is strong, and we can't hide our cutter pride for them. Their best is yet to come. To be continued. I now ask the class of 2020, wherever you are watching us, to please stand. To Superintendent Norcia, in my capacity as Principal Farrell on High School, I am proud to state the following. High school graduation requirements are set forth by New Jersey State Statute and Administrative Code, Title 6A, Section 8, and Title 18A, Section 35. Locally, they are contained in Board of Education Policy 5460. Mr. Norcia, I certify that the students of the class of 2020 have met the graduation requirements of the Farallon Board of Education and of the state of New Jersey. Therefore, it is my honor to present the Farallon High School Cutters, class of 2020. Class 2020, you can sit back down and relax. And now our superintendent of schools, Mr. Nick Norcia.
As superintendent of schools and on behalf of the Board of Education, I would like to offer a heartfelt congratulations to the class of 2020. Although we may not be here in person, nothing will diminish or dim your light on the rite of passage, graduation. Whether it be virtually or physically, you have earned it, and I am proud of you. I think back to earlier in the year as we discussed what this school year would have in hold for us and how exciting it would be. All the plans that were discussed by our monthly student dialogue meetings, athletics, preparing for another strong spring season, the upcoming school play, and ironically, writing your yearbook, to be continued. Yes, to be continued. Who would have thought? How fitting for this class. What makes this class so special is one simple thing. This pandemic will not define you. It will not be how you are remembered. This class will be remembered as the class that time and time again faced the challenge. And every time you stood tall, you remained professional. You handled it with grace. You were eloquent and you didn't let it define you. You showed what the true definition of resilience would be and what perseverance looks like and the true meaning of hope now more than ever. I want to be honest with you. As you are about to embark on the next chapter of your life and into the real world, it will not always be easy. But this class, more than any other class ever, knows what it means to be resilient, to be strong in the face of adversity, and to not let one singular event define you. Life is not always easy. Sometimes you may get knocked down. It happens. But you will know how to pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and rise again, because you are Fairlawn strong. This is the class of 2020 that is resilient. This is the class of 2020 that persevered through a tough second half of the school year. And this is the class of 2020 that had hope. When I think about the class of 2020, I often think about what former President Barack Obama said about hope. Hope is not blind optimism. It's not ignoring the enormity of the task ahead or the roadblocks that stand in our path. It's not sitting on the sidelines or shirking from a fight. Hope is that thing inside us that insists, despite all the evidence to the contrary, that something better awaits us if we have the courage to reach for it and to work for it and to fight for it. Hope is the belief that destiny will not be written for us, but by us, by the men and women who are not content to settle for the world as it is, who have the courage to remake the world as it should be. So I tell you, class of 2020, there are three things that no one, and I mean no one, can take away from you: your resiliency, your hope, and as my parents always said, where you came from, Fairlawn. Through this whole pandemic, you have made me immensely proud of how you handled this pandemic, and I wouldn't expect anything less than the class of 2020. I thank you, and I thank your parents who raised you well. Once again, as superintendent, on behalf of the Fairlawn Board of Education, I congratulate you, class of 2020. Good luck and stand tall. You deserve it. To accept our class of 2020 and confer their diplomas, the president of the Fairlawn Board of Education, Mr. Ron Barbarullo.
Good evening, graduates, parents, family, friends, faculty, and administrators. I know this isn't how we all thought tonight would go. Your senior year didn't end as you originally planned. The entire Board of Education, administration, and staff feel your pain. But despite this, you have weathered the grief and disappointment with immeasurable class and grace, and have emerged more resilient than ever before. For that alone, I applaud you. The future is always filled with change and uncertainty, now more than ever. But despite how trying times can be, especially these times, the silver lining in this adversity makes us stronger. So face change head on. Embrace uncertainty for what it is, possibility. If 2020 has shown us anything, it's that things don't always go as planned. But as John Lennon once said, life is what happens when you're busy making other plans. It's the little things along the way, the happy accidents and changed minds and new ideas that help you grow into the person you want to be. Though it may not seem like it right now, there is a world of opportunity open to you. Whatever your next adventure in life, whether it is college, trade school, a gap year, job hunting, or just trying to piece together a new normal, remember to enjoy every moment you can. And don't be afraid of things not working out your way you thought they would. Things fall apart so that the better things can fall together. So, class of 2020, I hope you are not just successful, but that you redefine success. Find whatever is important to you and work for it. Build the foundation of integrity, honesty, character, and love. Be resourceful and hopeful and brave. Look to make a difference in this world now more than ever. Travel if you can, read for fun, learn something new every day. Volunteer. Be kind always. You've proven this year how resilient you are and I have no doubt that you will overcome everything and anything thrown your way. It has been a joy and honor to watch all you grow into fine young adults. On behalf of the Board of Ed, I want to wish you all as much success and happiness life can bring. Congratulations and the best of luck. Thank you.
Abelaide.
Alexa Abreu.
Elvina Absalimova.
Itai Afriat.
Gabriel Aguero.
Lonnie Aharoni.
Tommy Alexander.
Hanan Ali.
Marie Alvarado.
Babatunde G. Amusu.
Eric Andrushkovich.
Kayla Shea Anello.
Daniel Araya. Diana Olivia Arva.
Yarden Atia.
Nicole Ann Augusto.
Giovanna Avalos.
Ryan Joseph Axe.
Aria Bali.
Jane Baranova.
Joe Barbarullo.
Nassim Berrigan.
Ejem Bashki.
Brian Bates.
Jokar Batista.
Victoria Bednars.
Jonathan Balilla.
Anthony Bensavenga.
Noah Ben Nunn.
Mark Berry.
Bernice Bijou.
Chanel Besor.
Otar Lashavili.
Richard Boeda.
Nicholas Bobert.
Melissa Bocanegra.
Bimesh Bomaretti.
Jacob Breitkoff.
Thais Brenner.
Amelia Lynn Brazaz.
Nathaniel Leonardo Brazaz.
Haley Browers.
Leonard Breutman.
John Biurek.
Bailey Cahill.
Courtney Alexander Campbell.
Jillian Carbine.
Michelle Castaneda.
Lisbeth Castillo.
Sloan Hannah Kavanaugh.
Ethan Caveda.
Jack Centeno.
Garrett Chamberlain.
Shreya Chipagane.
Omkar Chauhan.
Iman Chima.
Celine Chahab.
Chloe Childs.
Ethan Childs.
Brooke Tyler Chinchar.
Brianna Ashley Silofo.
Jason Cohen.
Caitlin Cohen.
Mayor Cohen.
Shira Cohen.
Jared Maxwell Cologne.
Samantha Carallo.
Devin Cornine.
Kylie Cottrell.
Selena Felicita Crawford.
Marnie Crown.
Yarden Dadon.
Caitlin Deal.
Rebecca Deldana.
Margie H. Desai.
Ogas Devrim.
David Roland Diaz.
Angelina Dong.
Joseph Donahoe.
Danny Dunnigan.
Joey Dutzar.
Russell Doretsky.
Emily Eisenberg.
Hassan Alahi.
Aaron Elazai.
Alfredis Emmanuel Zorilla.
Dennis Epstein.
Jarissa Escalona.
Randy Espinal.
Phil Esposito.
Jenna Falkenheim.
Breno Farias.
Bruno Farias.
Tommy Fasano.
Chris Fabetta.
Zoe Fazio.
Alberto Fernandez.
Eric Alexander French.
Joel Fife.
Arlene Flores.
Samantha Fox.
Kayla Alexis Francisco.
Nick Frangione.
Anthony Frangosa.
Zachary Fridlin.
Simona Friedman.
Alejandro Gabella.
Amelia Garcia.
Pamela Garcia.
Xavier Daniel Garcia.
Max Garval.
Alicia Gavzi.
Marquis Gerald.
Jenna Lee Gerritsen.
Nicole Gianella.
Kathy Giorgio Biani.
Jacqueline Giz.
Isabella July.
Kelsey Gomez.
Veronica Gomez.
Julia Gonda.
Evan Gonzalez.
Caitlin Gonzalez.
Daniel Ketter.
Alex Gostev.
Tristan Greff.
Nicholas John Groetsema.
Edon Gutkin.
Theodore Halbach.
Eric Aaron Hansen.
Danielle Harari.
Ayana Harper.
Tatiana Hauser.
Jessica Hayes.
Alexander Hassami.
Michael Hickey.
Timofey Hushin.
Yusef Hussein.
Ia Irajuli.
Maria Ibanez.
Anthony Ignacio.
Michael Incabo.
Alec John Incremona.
Charlize Ira Tagotia.
Kyle Irby Mason.
Richard Isaac.
Lana Jaber.
Anisha Jamil.
Josh Jimenez.
Alexandra Jonides.
Ryan John.
Jaden Johnson.
Jessica Jordan.
Robert Joyce.
Ari Julius.
Amelia Yushachak.
Hisham Cater.
Risa Kanai.
Thomas Kapotis.
Emily Ann Kasserman.
Simrat Kaur.
Stephen Walter Kalin.
Mariam Hajinski.
Mohammed Kadir.
Christine Kim.
Pearl Kim.
Nivedita Kintukara.
Brandon Matthew Kingsley.
Michael Kinkov.
Danielle Klein.
Ariel Knopf.
Nicole Kohanic.
Jacob Coppell.
Benjamin Colker.
Elron Conyo.
Casper Kowal.
Allison Celia Kramer.
Jake Krebs.
Lons Lobbit.
Sasha Lachter.
Shauna Ladd.
Alizara Lai.
Adrian Lamboy.
Jarrett Lang.
Joseph M. Larson.
Justin Labette.
Tiffany Lashinsky.
Jordan Lehman.
Kunhee Lim.
Ben Liss.
Sarah Londner.
Jonathan Lugo.
Gabriel Matthew Lumaj Luyen.
Yardin Mack.
Kauser Kasim Madha.
Abigail Makovos.
Liam Malloy.
Kevin Mamo.
Noah Mandel the Third.
Jocelyn Manica.
Lauren Manning.
Tyler Mariani.
Nicole Genevieve Martignoni Mercado.
Ben Martinez.
Kelly Martinez.
Tyler Massey.
Ryan Mao.
Muntasir Maya.
Glenn Merritt.
Nadine Metwali.
Amir Michael.
C. Samuel M. Mittman.
Harisis Makos.
Ryan Molnar.
Roberto Andres Morales.
Ashley Moran.
Nicole Murillo.
Julia Christiana Morrison.
Samantha Angelina Muri.
Christina Nahas.
Ksenia Nakonechny.
Michael Naples.
Jake Thomas Nappy.
Dennis Narty.
Joshua Navarro.
Yam Nava.
Sheila Devargian Nilagiri.
Kenneth Nemec.
Artem Novoselov.
Christian Nunez.
Gabe O'Farrell.
Sean O'Malley.
Shane O'Shea.
Maya Okrasinska.
Miana Otenez.
Anissa Osbeck.
Kayla Pacheco.
Tipu Francis Palupetta.
Gabrielle Paradiso.
Mahi Pasarkar.
Ashana Patel.
Kinari Patel.
Michael Patel.
Alice Pavlov.
Melina Pavlova.
Michael Payano.
Haley Peguero.
Christian Nathaniel Perez.
Matt Perez.
Ryan William Perez.
Rachel Persky.
Alexandra Pires.
Benjamin Plasienko.
Zoe Polyakov.
Maria Popova.
Grace Portvalit.
Brian R. Poets.
Joshua Prakash.
Terrence Pridmore.
AJ Porto.
Pratik Rai.
Kayla Ramirez.
Janet Raidman.
Jamin Reyes.
Helen Reynoso.
Marco Reynoso.
Yogev Rickin.
Julia Rios.
Julia Ryrak.
Amy Rivera.
Elizabeth Rivera.
Enrique Daniel Rodriguez.
Antonio Lorenzo Rodriguez.
Dania Isabel Rodriguez.
Julio Rojo.
Miguel Angel Roman.
John Rosso.
Luis Rubio.
Ashley Caitlin Rue.
Mark Ruley.
Alexandra Sacinelli.
Janice Salazar.
Eitan Ori Skolnick.
Jake Schroeder.
Eliana Shuck.
Andrew Schultz.
Marissa Schwartz.
Rajvi Shah.
Zane Shazad.
Juliana Shala.
Anna Seamus.
Jacob Shapiro.
Colin Shelton.
Barbara Shevlin.
Kayla Ann Sefkin.
Justin Silva.
Kirsten Joan Singer.
Akashdeep Singh.
Gayan Singh.
Sandeep Singh.
Erin Sinisi.
Emery Sisman.
Alina Smirnova.
Mackenzie Smith.
Adrian Wiso.
Darius Sohikish.
Zoe Sohikish.
Julia Sorrentino.
Francesca Soto.
Nathaniel Sullivan Steen.
Maxim Stepanov.
Isabella Stoll.
Charlie Strasser.
Miles Sukoff.
Or Sandieski.
Shoreya Syed.
Nicholas Tatuli.
Marina Toffelis.
Elliot Taylor.
Michael Taylor.
Gracie Terpstra.
Roman Tisi.
Albina Tokakova.
Michael Tokar.
TJ Tomesco.
Rebecca Toothman.
Samantha Toronto.
Calvin Torres.
Daniel Torres.
Kelvin Torres.
Tiffany Tran.
Frankie Renee Trinidad.
Sophia Trinidad.
Eric Trostin.
Medha Tulsiani.
Joseph Tui.
Pavel Albert Uchitel Bukur.
Minaj Udin.
Alondra Uriarte.
Tiller Uriarte.
Juan Uribe.
Russell James Van Houten.
Carlos Enrique Velasquez.
Elijah J. Velez.
Jade Rose Vanette.
Oscar A. Vera.
Dennis Vink.
Gio Visbal.
Gabe Vu.
Guy Wasserman.
Jordan Weber.
Danielle White.
Anaya Wiggs.
Danica Wilner.
Harry Winnick.
Maggie Winnick.
Alex Work.
Michael York.
Daisy Zapata.
Emma Zerka.
Alice Zhang.
Zeping Zhang.
Druzilla Zhang.
Jack Jingyi Zhang.
Patrick Thomas Zadik.
Matan Zilber.
Tomer Zilber.
Yonatan Zilberman.
Giselle Zimmerman.
Chris Zisa.
Noah Zuckerman.
To present the class gift, the treasurer of the class of 2020, Maya Okrasinska.
Over the past 4 years, our class has raised money through road sales, bake sales, food nights, class dances, and of course, our classic morning bagel sales. On behalf of the class of 2020, I would like to present how we will use our remaining funds to leave our impact here on campus. As a token to our community's commitment to future success of Fairlawn students, we will continue the scholarship legacy that was initiated in 2016. This will help future graduating FLHS seniors to achieve their goals in higher education. Additionally, in light of changing times, we will install a new welcome sign in front of the auditorium by the B-Gym, replacing the current outdated one. Using our remaining savings, we will set up a teardrop fund for the three classes that we've shared time with at FLHS. This fund will account for the valuable fundraising time they lost due to our shortened school year, aiding in their future endeavors. And finally, to ensure that our practice has a lasting effect at FLHS, we will be planting a tree in the class of 2020's name. This tree will stand as a symbol that marks our growth as scholars and as individuals over the past years at Fairlawn High School. It will persevere through rainy and stormy days, the same way our class has persevered through the unideal circumstances we have been faced with due to the pandemic. Our time may have been cut short, but through these varying gifts, our legacy will remain at FLHS forever. Before I end, I want to thank all of our advisors, administrators, parents, students, and anyone else who helped us succeed and fundraise over these 4 years. Now we all have the opportunity to go on and leave our legacies on the world around us. Thank you.
To share his speech, titled The Class of 2020, Some Have a Story, We Made History. Class President, Dennis Vink.
I've been a class president for 4 years now. For 4 years, I've been thinking of this speech. The last speech I'd give to not only my class, but my friends. Now, let's be honest, we all expected to be on Sasso Field, all dressed in our red gowns. We all expected to have a senior prom. We all expected to be able to be together, and not only hear the speech, but to graduate like the 75 classes before us. But we're not. Maybe it's because we're simply the most legendary class to exist. Who knows? I mean, we know we are. But instead, we are sitting at home, listening to my pre-recorded stuff, which is definitely tough considering I can't crack any jokes live. But the honest truth is we can't dwell on the past. We can't go back in time without the coronavirus, but we can learn from the past, and we are learning from the past. Showed us how precious life truly is. From a pillar of community like Jerry, who wasn't only a bus driver, but also a father and an amazing person, to other family members in our community who we lost during these unsatisfactory times, we stand together. No matter how many people tell us this will be a lesson for a lifetime to come, I can't help but think of the lessons we gained from our 4 years. Now, I don't want to make this a boring story of how we came to the high school as little kids, and now we're all almost 18 and graduating, but I have to. Let's take a step back. September 6, 2016, we walked into school as prepubescent and children with as much knowledge as any of us had in passing physics. We roamed around the school, and in about a month, we knew it like the back of our hand. We had a freshman class trip to Point Pleasant, the real class counselors remember that. And we had a freshman dance in the cafeteria, which is pretty damn fancy. Sophomore year, we held the first real rose sales in our high school career. We sold over 300 roses to the young couples of our high school. One of the greatest sophomore semifinals in history. You guys must have recorded about that. Junior year came way too quickly, and we began to feel the pressures. APs, college selections, starting to drive. Everyone was growing up super fast. We may have had some parking problems outside of school, all thanks to everyone who double parked, specifically Shireya. Plenty of parking tickets to pay for it. And by the time April rolled around, we had junior prom in the B-Gym, which, let me tell you, was a step up from the A-Gym sophomore year. And we ended junior year ready to go into a normal senior year with a normal grade, but we already know we are anything but a normal grade. So we only had about 6 months of real senior year. And before we knew it, we were in the final steps of our high school career. Now, what I did not mention in that brief history of our 4 years was all the effort every single one of us put in. I mean, for real. The long hours, put into making the school play amazing. The long hours, the orchestra, band, and marching band all put into getting nationally ranked. The effort at every club, honor society, even sport had in running a bake sale or winning leagues or even states. Shout out boys volleyball. But those accomplishments all came from you guys. You may have not realized it, but because of you guys, I'm proud to say I'm the president of the Fairlawn High School Class 2020. And because of you guys, I wanted to keep working hard to organize class dance after class dance, no matter how cringy they were. We are all going to the next chapter of our lives with the experience that many don't have, but many strive for. Because you all worked hard in whatever you did throughout high school. You know what it takes to prevail and keep on moving. And we're going down as one of the most resilient classes in school history. This will be a lesson for the rest of our lives. A lesson about perseverance, diligence, and most importantly, unity. I like to think of high school using a quote a great mentor of mine once said. High school is a lot like toilet paper. You only miss it once it's gone. And I definitely think we experienced a shortage of toilet paper. Thank you guys for an adventurous 4 years. Thank you to all our great teachers, custodians, parents, administrators, and everyone who helped us succeed over these 4 years. I wish you all the best of luck, and I'll see you all at the 10-year reunion.
To sing the Fairlawn High School alma mater, Alondra Uriarte.
Our strong band can never be broken, formed at Fairlawn High, by suppressing wealth unspoken, filled with friendship's tide. Alma mater, alma mater, deep graven on each heart, shall be found unwavering true when we from thee shall part. High school life at best is passing, gliding swiftly by. Let us pledge in word and deed our love for Fairlawn High. Alma mater, alma mater, deep graven on each heart, shall be found unwavering true when we from thee shall part.
Cutters, you have officially graduated Fairlawn High School. Turn your tassels from right to left. Look up. Make sure the ceiling's not too close. On the count of three. One, two, three. Congratulations, Fairlawn High School, class of 2020.
This is nice. Still trying to break every single rule. Thank you. ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll sail the world to find you. If you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light to guide you. Find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me like 1, 2, 3, I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you like 4, 3, 2, and you'll be there. Cause that's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah. Tossing and you're turning and you just can't fall asleep, I'll sing a song beside you. And if you ever forget how much you really mean to me, every day I will remind you. Oh, find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me like 1, 2, 3, I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you like 4, 3, 2, and you'll be there. Cause that's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah.
Cause in a
get lighter the more it gets dark. I'm gonna give you my heart.